Nice to see you. I feel nervous about today, but hello. So whilst I appreciate you guys a lot donating bits and also donating gifting subs, I would actually rather for today's stream, all of that energy and beautiful generosity goes towards Alzheimer's Research UK. You can actually do !donate. And it will bring up the link that you guys need to donate on Tiltify. I obviously don't feel like you have to donate, but any donations are obviously very, very much appreciated. I've worked with Alzheimer's UK a bunch in the past. If you guys remember my Share the Orange campaign that I did where I was holding an orange. Speaking of orange, why am I so freaking yellow? Like, let me see if I can like change that real quick because I'm so yellow. I don't know why I'm so yellow today. I'm not even using any different makeup or anything, and it's really, really weirding me out. Okay, will this change it? No, that's not doing a thing. Heh? Why am I so yellow? Oh wait, it's this one. No, it is that one. Yeah, that's me. Why am I so yellow? I don't know. Okay, let me see if this helps a little bit. Okay. No. Ooh. Oh wow. I'm kind of looking like Shrek. Kind of Shrekking it up in here. Okay. There. That's a little bit less yellow and a little bit more pink. I think that's potentially a bit better. I can turn this up one as well. Okay, is that better? Is that a little bit less better? Wait, a little bit more better, not less better. Oh, also. Need to get some more peach juice. So yeah, today, if you are able to donate, I will be reading out all of the donations as well. I know a bunch of you guys donated before I even started streaming today, which was so freaking awesome. I will also match donations as we did with WWF. So yeah, I worked with Alzheimer's UK for a campaign 2 years ago called Share the Orange. Was it a year ago? No, 2 years ago called Share the Orange. And the reason we shared the orange is because if you imagine my hand holding an orange, that is about how much brain matter somebody with Alzheimer's or dementia loses. So it's really quite, when you look at an orange, like they're pretty big. It's quite like a scary amount of brain matter to lose. And the whole idea behind, yeah, I still look really yellow, don't I? I don't know. The whole idea behind sharing the orange is to try and kind of demonstrate that so people can kind of, like actually have a physical way of understanding how kind of the actual physical impact of Alzheimer's and dementia. So the reason that this is very close to my heart particularly is because 3 years ago today, I remember that because it was the day before Bonfire Night, which is a big night in the UK with fireworks and all of that kind of stuff. That is actually the day that I lost my grandma Mudge. And that was 3 years ago today. But honestly, if you have experienced losing a family member to Alzheimer's or dementia, you will know that it's actually, you end up losing that person a long time before that. So I actually lost my grandma a long time before that. And then what happens is you're kind of then caring for a person that isn't the same person as the person you knew and loved, a person that is in many ways, the illness turns them into a shell of what they once were. And I don't mean that in a mean way about my grandma, like my grandma would have 100% agreed with me because my grandma had so much personality and so much fire, and like the person that she was after suffering from dementia for many years is just not that person, and she would completely agree with me on that. And I was very, very close with my grandma. My mum and dad both still say to me, there's so much Grandma Madge in you. Like, we were very similar people. And I spent a lot of time with my grandma as a kid because both my parents worked really long hours. My mum actually did an 8-8 shift. So she'd start work at 8 a.m. and finish at 8 p.m, which is just crazy long hours. So I used to spend a lot of time at my grandma's house. I used to go there after school, and I used to go there on weekends. And basically, I just spent a lot of time with my grandma Madge. She's my dad's mum. So we were very, very close growing up. We had all of these like things that we were both really into because we both liked plants. We both loved animals. Like, she was just really amazing for all that kind of stuff. And we'd go on walks with my little brother and like go and see like donkeys or horses, or like she'd point out all the different plants, or she'd take us blackberry picking and strawberry picking. Like, she was just very much that kind of vibe, and I also have a lot of that vibe in me as well, which is really, really cool. She was also super outspoken. She was never afraid of having opinions. And I feel like I have a lot of that in me as well. So basically, we were just very, very similar people. And I miss her a lot. And even though it's been 3 years, I keep having these kind of, I think that everyone does when they lose somebody, these new little waves of things that hit you. So when I was struggling with my indoor plants, my first thought was to try and pick up the phone and ring my grandma Madge. And so it was really hard not being able to do that. And actually, weirdly enough, when I shaved my head and my hair grew back, I looked in the mirror and I was just my grandma Madge. Like, we had the same, I can just see her in me so, so much. So I keep kind of having these extra little waves of losing somebody, which I think is the case when, thank you guys so much for the hype train. I will read out all your messages. Don't worry, I'm gonna read out everything. I just wanna kind of get this little piece off my chest. I think it's probably the case with a lot of people when you lose somebody, you don't just lose them once, you lose them in waves over and over and over again. But each wave gets a little bit gentler and a little bit softer. But yeah, that is kind of, that is my grandma Madge, and she was pretty amazing and wonderful. And dementia is horrible. Dementia is really, really horrible. Because when my grandma had dementia for, I would say it's probably about 7 years. And eventually she wasn't able to care for herself anymore. So she went into a home specifically for people with Alzheimer's and dementia. And I would go and visit her with my family, and kind of early on she stopped being able to recognize me, which was really, really hard. And I'm talking about this not to try and like be a sob story, I'm just giving you guys a bit of context. I'm sure a lot of you guys have gone through something similar, so I wanted to like I think it's important to talk about this stuff. So yeah, she'd at first, like, if I said, no, grandma, it's me, it's Clare, then she'd be like, oh, of course, Clare, how are you? And in fact, wait there 1 minute, because I want to show you guys something. Wait. Hi, I'm back. So when she first started to forget myself, she had a bunch of grandchildren, because, you know, Irish, we sure love to procreate. I actually, for Christmas 1 year, made her this book. And it's... Here, to my grandma Madge, here is, oh no, there we go. To my grandma Madge, here is a photo album of all our wonderful memories with you from Clare, from Michael and Clare and Dane. But I put this together while I was in London, and it's like me, shall I do this for a sec? Here we go. It's me and all of my family and all of the grandchildren from when we were little, that's me. From when we were like little, that's me as well. Little tiny babies from like us growing up, because and she had this with her. That's my cousin, that's me, that's us all again, that's me. And me again with my grandma. Right, sorry, can you guys see this? Okay, what about if I do this? So yeah, I thought that if she had this book and she could see us like all growing up, then it would help her with like remembering who we all were. That's me as well, I'm her little brother Dane. So yeah, the book is full of pictures of all my grandkids, all the grandkids, all my cousins basically, and us, all like growing up. It's a bunch of this basically. And that's my grandma, that's me. I look a bit scary there. But yeah, I figured that if she saw us all growing up, then it might help her with like remembering, remembering us all. That's me with blonde hair. So that's us all getting older and older, and like all of us turning into adults, getting our degrees and all of that kind of thing. And I figured that if she saw this book and saw us all growing up, then it might help her, because we all look so different, particularly the girls in my family. We'd all dyed our hair, we'd all just changed so much, like in our appearance and stuff. So I thought that if, sorry, I'm really yellow. I keep looking at the screen and being really, I don't know why I look so yellow. I thought that if she saw the pictures of us growing up, it might help her with linking back to who we were. Because in her head, we were all like 10 and we weren't. We were like in our 20s. We were like full grown adults, like who'd moved away. So every time I saw her, I had to be like, oh, grandma, it's me, it's Clare. I'm Michael's daughter. I moved to London, but I come back up and see you. and eventually she'd remember. And then, oh my gosh, we hit the goal already. Oh, guys, I'm going to read out every single donation message. Don't worry, I will read out every single one. I would... Oh my gosh. This is the eulogy I read at a funeral. I didn't realize that was in there. Okay. But then eventually she would stop being able to remember me, and I have a really vivid memory of driving her to my dad's house. We were in the car, me and my grandma were sat in the back, and I'd managed to remind her who I was, and I was holding her hand and like talking to her and telling her like, "Grandma, it's really nice to see you, you look lovely, I'm glad you remember me." She was smiling and smiling, and she was looking at me, and then her face changed and she looked really frightened because she didn't know who I was, and I was holding her hand. She was scared. So yeah, it got really, really tough. She'd never remember who I was, and it got to a point where I couldn't stop being emotional around her and crying. And that's not fair on her because she's confused. She doesn't understand. She's not forgetting me to hurt me. I couldn't not get upset. So it is a really, really horrible way to lose someone. And that's why I'm trying to raise money for Alzheimer's research, because there are breakthroughs, there are things that we're discovering, we're understanding more about the brain all the time, and I think that eventually we will be able to have a cure for this. And so no one else will have to go through what I went through, and what anyone else in this chat went through, what my family went through. You guys are saying my grandma not recognizing me was the worst thing ever happening to me. It's really, really hard, really hard. In fact, I'm gonna do a little poll in the chat now. Let me know how many of you guys has your family been touched by dementia or Alzheimer's? Am I spelling Alzheimer's right? It's not the easiest thing to spell. There we go. So I just kind of want to find out how many of you guys in the chat have known somebody in your family or your friends or anyone that has been touched by this, so we can kind of get a little bit of an understanding as to just how widespread this is. So yeah, and if you have stories you want to share in the chat and you guys talking to each other, and I'll read out your message and stuff, then that's absolutely fine. It is meant to be a little bit of a support stream and a little bit of an education stream. I had forgotten where this was. I thought I'd wrote it in a bullet journal that I don't use anymore. I thought I'd lost this eulogy. I don't know if I can read this out, but I spoke at my grandma's funeral because I really wanted to, I held it together and I didn't, well, halfway through I had to stop and gather myself, and then I continued and I read the whole thing. But I really wanted to do one last thing for her to make her proud, because I know it would have done, and yeah, I will read this. This is, okay. I will read this, okay. As you can imagine, memory and the role it played in the latter part of our grandma's life has been something I'm sure we've all thought about a lot. How lucky we are then to have had a grandma like Madge in our lives, who has given us so many moments and memories to think on. A grandma who would sit with us on the floor of her bungalow, crafting little paper spiders, who grew sunflowers with us that towered over our heads, and of course, yield a respectable crop of potatoes. We used to grow potatoes in buckets at my grandma's house. A grandma who would take us on long walks to pick berries and feed horses, and who put up with us shouting, "Nanny!" for years over our garden fence. She actually lived right behind us, so we used to go over the fence to say hi to her. Our grandma was of course known for her sage advice, to keep her a prisoner, that's for money, and who would always speak her mind, speak the truth, as she would say. How wonderfully fitting it is then that the words I can still hear her say most clearly are those of how proud she was of us all, whose face I can still picture when she says well done. How happy she was to see all of her grandchildren succeed thanks to the role that she played in our lives. Yet despite her strong will, it was her compassion that I think about every day and try to emulate after her example. to see things from the perspective of others and to not harm those who do nothing to you. Don't hurt him to any spider we found in our house who disliked even the word hate. She gave us 1,000 more memories than could ever have been taken from her, and she will live on through every one of them. Thank you, Grandma Marge, for everything. We will continue to always make you proud, and we will have a million dollar hug again sometime soon. Oh gosh, sorry guys. Oh my gosh. So a million dollar hug is something me and my grandma used to have together, and it was like our like secret thing whenever I'd leave the house. At her house, you guys know, if you've met me in person, I hug really tightly. So I used to, whenever I said bye to my grandma, I used to hug her really tightly, and she would say, oh, that's my $1 million hug. If it was one hug or $1 million, I'd pick that hug every time. Oh, so yeah, I think I broke down at the exact same bit as when I read that out at my grandma's funeral, so. Oh, sorry, I didn't want to like make it all overly emotional and upsetting, but I also had forgotten all the words to that, so it was actually really nice of me to read that again. Oh. So yeah, also, it's not something, having emotions and crying is a good thing, so I don't mind doing it on stream. I don't mind getting upset on stream. Oh, that was so beautiful and emotional, sending you big hugs, Claire. Charlotte, thank you so much, sending all of you guys big hugs together. Oh, jeez. I also wanted to check the poll. 54% of you guys, I'm gonna vote obviously because I'm in it. So 54% of you guys have been touched by dementia or Alzheimer's. So that's, if you're stood next to one other person, chances are they have, if you haven't been affected by Alzheimer's or dementia, which is really, really high. So yeah. Oh gosh. Sorry to get upset. I don't mean to be bring a downer on it, but I'm really glad I read that because I'd forgotten all of the words in that. So, yeah. Oh, guys, you guys in the chat getting upset. Oh, okay. I'm going to catch up with the messages from the donations now. Picture of me and Ali fell out. I don't know where that came from, but... And Evie. I wanted to catch up with your guys' donations on Tiltify because... I set a goal, I know when we did the WWF thing, I set the goal there for 10,000, but when we did the WWF thing, we did it for a whole month, and this was just for one day, so I set the goal for 1,000, and we've actually already raised £1,281, which is just absolutely crazy, so I'm gonna do exactly what I did last time, which is, let me make sure I can get this up properly. Where is Chrome? Should I choose as Genshin? Okay, there's a little hype train choo-chooing down the bottom there, but we'll just hide that. And then I'm gonna add in, will it let me do it on Chrome? Yay! Okay, so let me just make it a little bit bigger. There we go. Okay, because I want to read your guys' donation messages out in the stream. So Nicole Esposito has donated £200. Nicole, you're a top donor. Every little helps. This is such a great cause to support. Much love. Nicole, thank you so, so much. Thank you so, so much. And also, oh my gosh, I had music on for the whole of that. I didn't actually realize. I switched it off. I've been in silence. £200 is so generous and so amazing. Thank you so, so much. That's just absolutely crazy. Don't forget, if you do want to donate, you can type in !! Donate. If you can't donate, don't worry. If you actually write do !! Dementia. Did I spell that right? Yeah. Then you can learn. I don't know if I've spelled dementia right. I think I have. Then you can just learn more about it. And that is just as important. So, Nicole, thank you so, so much. Diana, thank you so, so much for donating as well. I've lost my grandpa 2 years ago to Alzheimer's. Nobody ever loved me the way he did. Thank you so much for doing this, Claire. You are amazing. Thank you so, so much for donating. Dreamers Arcadia, thank you so, so much for donating as well. I really don't have a lot of money, but I wanted to donate at least a little. I've been lucky enough not to have family affected by this, but I've met people who were affected. This is a lovely cause and I'm proud of you. I'm sure your grandmother is too. Peachy hugs and love. Dreamers Arcadia, thank you so, so much. damage. Nick Med has also donated a small amount, but I hope it helps. It's not small at all. Please don't feel like any donation is amazing. Please don't ever feel like shameful for how much you donate, okay? Heather, thank you so much for donating as well. For my dad in the early stages, I'm so sorry you're going through that, Heather. Linnea has donated £10 as well. My great grandma died of Alzheimer's, and it was so sad to watch her forget everyone, including her own daughters. Thank you so much for this. Linnea, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry that you went through that as well. Clara V, thank you so much for donating as well. Hi, Claire, sending lots of love to you and thoughts to your grandma. My grandfather had Alzheimer's too, and it was really hard losing him bits by bits this way. You make my life a bit better each time. Peachy love. Clara, thank you so much. Anonymous also, thank you so much for donating £10. Thank you. Anna Maria, thank you so much for donating as well. Hi Claire, I love you so much. I'm so sorry for your loss. I lost my granddad the same way in February, and for you to be doing this is so amazing. Just know that your grandma is looking down at you and she's very proud of you. Love you, angel. Stay strong. Thank you so much, Anna Maria. Ed, thank you so much as well. Said love the streams. CC Bear 27, thank you so much for donating as well. And also, Miss Reva Gaming, thank you so much for donating to you. Oh, you guys, I'm never gonna be able to get to page two because you guys have been so amazing. Thank you so much, Miss Reva Games. And also, Noor, thank you so much for donating. I love you always and I'm so proud of you. Just like your grandma is, she's always there with you. I wish I could donate more. Please don't feel like you have to. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Is it gonna let me go to page two? There we go. Okay. And then we've also got Ed, who's donated £4. Loved your streams. Breezy Cheesy has donated £20. I lost my grandma 6 years ago to Alzheimer's. I think what you're doing is amazing. Breezy Cheesy, thank you so much. Micro Simmer, also £20. You're so fantastic raising money for this cause. I'm from the US, but I also lost a grandparent with Alzheimer's. I appreciate you talking about your grandmother and your experience of essentially losing them twice. That is exactly how I would describe it. Hugs to you. Hugs to you as well. Nicole, I can't believe you donated £200, babes. That is amazing. Thank you so much. And also, Eyebrow Twitch Haley has donated too. Hi, Claire, watching the stream. I don't normally donate for things, but I decided I wanted to donate $5 all the way from Washington State. I've been here supporting since the beginning of Dreamhouse. I love you, and I'm proud of all you do for us in this community. Thank you so much, Haley. Olivia Faith is £25. Alzheimer's and dementia run in my family. My mum lost her uncle this year due to this awful disease, and it was really hard seeing all of this. I'm so sorry about your grandma, and I admire your strength. Thank you for supporting such a beautiful cause. Olivia, thank you so much. I'm so sorry it runs in your family. Mull Pigeon, thank you so much for donating as well. I love you, Claire. £20, thank you so much. Gem, £10, you're amazing for doing this. Thank you so much. Anonymous, also donating £5. I remember meeting my grandpa's sister for the first time. She had Alzheimer's, and I think it was the saddest thing I've seen. She sat in the middle of her room in a chair. She didn't speak, she didn't move. I know how incredibly sad this is. It takes that person away in a really big way. Thank you so much for donating. Irene as well, Irene H. Johnson with £5. I lost my grandpa to Alzheimer's a few years ago. In the end, he didn't recognize any of his loved ones. I hope in the future we can avoid more people experience this horrible illness. Thank you, Claire, for raising money for charity. You're amazing. Much love from Norway. Thank you so much, Irene. A kitty cat. A kitty cat with a charity itch. £100. Oh my gosh, I'm donating on behalf of all the peaches that can't donate themselves. Oh my gosh, big hugs for you. Can we get some hearts in the chat, please? That is crazy, £100. Seadrug 13, £50 Seadrug. My grandfather had dementia following a series of strokes, so this cause has always been near and dear to my heart. It's such a difficult disease to watch a family member have, and I'm so thankful that you are raising awareness. A huge thank you to you and to everyone that donates. Seadrug, thank you so much. Elsie with £10 as well, you are amazing, and thank you for raising for the money for this cause. Love you. And also Pumpkin Spice Cats, thank you so much for donating £10. Thank you so much for the hearts. Thank you guys for doing hearts in the chat. That's so nice. Tia Loves Claire, £45. Here's the money that I remember you mentioned you were selling some stuff to get some donation money. Here's the money that I've raised for today's stream and some of my own. My granddad is currently in hospital fighting this, and honestly, it's not looking too good, but I'm staying positive. We are all incredibly proud of you, Claire, and I promise you that your grandma is too. Sending you all my love. Stay strong. Oh my gosh, can we get some love in the chat for Tia? That is amazing. Dragon Tears Paul, Tears Paul, thank you so much for the £5 donation. Creep Mother, that's one of our more. Tia Beth, thank you so much for the donation as well. £20. Anonymous, thank you so much for donating £10. A Hayes 2118, thank you so much for donating £10 too. We lost my grandpa to Alzheimer's almost 2 years ago. Today would have been his 81st birthday. Thank you for raising money for such a great cause. A Hayes, thank you so much for the donation. Oh my gosh, you guys. Miranda Chavez, £30. Thank you so, so much, Miranda. Rokia Martel, £20. It's not much, but I hope it helps. It is. Rian, am I saying that right? £7. I lost my nan to Alzheimer's 3 years ago in January. It's sending you, sending love to you and all the Peach Squad. Rian, thank you so, so much. Laura Johnson donating £10 as well there. That's LawZJ12. Thank you so much for £10 there for an amazing cause. Thank you. Honda's Mama 2005. Thank you so, so much for the £20 donation. Easy Breezy, thank you so much for the £20. Hey Claire, love that you're doing this. I also lost my grandma to Alzheimer's and dementia a couple of years ago. So I'm happy to help you raise money for research in the UK. Easy Breezy, thank you so, so much. Katie Cole, £50. Went through this with my grandpa. So many of you guys have had to go through this. I'm so sorry that you've all been through this. Happy to help raise money to fund research into this. Your grandma will be proud of you. Oh my gosh, a kitty. What? A kitty also. That's the same kitty cat before with the charity itch. They donated £200 too. We've got two top donors today. Nicole and a kitty cat with an itch. Oh my gosh, what? Please, 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 more hearts in the chat for a kitty cat with an itch. They donated £300. £300, what? Katie in Wonderland, thank you so much for £30. Both my nans have dementia and are both in homes and we aren't able to visit them. Love you lots. Of course, with everything with COVID. Jeez, I'm so sorry you're going through that. Georgia, £5, super proud of you. You're amazing for supporting such an amazing cause. Stay strong, Angel. Georgia, thank you so, so much. Also, Hannah a Lizard, you're always so generous. Hannah a Lizard, £100. So proud of you for all the amazing things you are doing for causes that are so close to your heart. You are such a special person with such a big heart and it shows. Thank you so, so much, Hannah. Lauren, £15. This actually means a lot to me as I've unfortunately lost two grandparents to this. It's so hard to lose someone this way, and I'm sending you my love to anyone going through this. You constantly make your grandma and all of us so proud. Keep fighting and never forget how strong you are. We love you. Lauren, the same back to you 100 times over. Thank you so, so much for the donation. My mom! My mom donated £20 as well. Oh, mom. Thank you so, so much. That's my mom and Calorie. And Ellery Kinney also, £95. Your grandma would be so proud of you. Stay strong. Thank you so much, Ellery Kinney. Johnny LFC. Oh my gosh, hi. Lost my grandma to Alzheimer's too. You are doing so much. I hope you raise a lot of money. Great work. Johnny, thank you so, so much. £20 there. Becca Y also donating £8.50. I think you were the first donation. Love you, Claire. Glad you are doing this. Thank you so, so much. Thank you. Thank you. £1,416. Oh my gosh, what? Lady Azareth with £5. It's not much, but I don't want this to happen to anyone. I love you. I love especially my granny. Peachy love. Lady Azareth, thank you so, so much. Also with the £5 donation and the heart. We've also got Rubicon 101 with the donation too. Claire, I'm feeling extremely privileged to not have somebody I know suffer from dementia. I can't imagine how it must feel to go through and to know a person who went through such a life-changing disease. This cause is bringing awareness and helping research into it. Your grandma would be proud of you. Rubicon, thank you so, so much. Laura, also with the £5 donation. Hi, I lost my great-grandma to dementia 3 years ago. It would have been just over a month after you lost your grandma. I'm watching your stream and crying because I'm remembering her. You are such an incredible person. Your videos make me laugh. They are the highlight of my day. Thank you. Mendes at Mende2601 as well with £20 donation. Thank you so much for supporting this. I am experiencing this with my grandpa right now. I simply have to donate. Really many thanks. Big hug from me. £20, Mende. Thank you so, so much. Emily also with the donation. My grandma had an aneurysm rupture. It's not Alzheimer's, but it made her lose lots of her memory and capacity. She cannot walk and her memory is stuck in the past. Losing her mind was her worst nightmare. I hope no one will live through this. Love you, Claire. It's a great cause. Emily, thank you so much. Lottie! Oh my gosh. Is Lottie here? Oh. Lottie, amazing that you're raising money and awareness for such a great cause, Claire. It's one close to my heart too. You're doing your grandma much proud. I wish I could give you a big hug. Love you lots. Lottie, I wish I could give you a hug as well. I miss hugging you. Spidey Hugs, thank you so much for £15. Donating for my grandma Lola, who I don't remember much because I was a baby, but I always hear stories. Oh no, let me catch the end of this. Oh my gosh, it's moving really fast. Let me go right back to the beginning, and it should be here, right? And I always hear stories about how great she was and how much she loved me. Spidey Hugs, thank you so much. Emily, Minor, thank you so much as well, £10. Thank you for sharing your story. Love you so, so much. Thank you so, so much. And we've had so many, oh my gosh. DJ the Jam Pump, £20. I'm fortunate enough to not have struggled with this in my family, but I also send all of my love to you and the Peaches who do. Love you all. DJ the Jam Pump, thank you so, so much. Simsy Sunshine, £10. I didn't have money when you did this for the WWF, but I'm glad I can donate to this cause. I've been fortunate enough not to have lost a loved one to this, but much love to those who have. Simsy, thank you so, so much. Jacob O'Connor, thank you so much for the donation too. It's not a lot as I can't afford more. Please know it's every little helps, but I know how important this cause is to you. Thank you so much, Jacob. Thor Hannah, £27, £10. I'm so sorry, your grandma. I'm so sorry about your grandma. You had me sobbing like a baby. Love you so much. Oh my gosh. Bok and Jay, hi, £20. For all of those who suffered with this illness and to hopefully help those experiencing the same, though we are separated by color, creed, location, or ideals, we can come together for their feelings of love and for our precious ones and for each other. Much love, Bok and Jay. That was such a beautiful message, Bok and Jay. Thank you so, so much. I love that you're always there saying hi to each other in my streams. Teagle, £40. Hey Claire, you're such a wonderful person. My nan has Parkinson's dementia and she always calls me my mum's name, who died 13 years ago. Jeez, Teagle, that must be so tough. Thank you so, so much for donating. I'm so, so sorry you're going through that. And Symbols H, £15.14. My great grandma is currently suffering from dementia, and when I went to visit her a couple of years back, she didn't even remember who I was, and it was so heartbreaking to know her and everything she had done for my family, but not have her remember any of it. That's such a like important thing to say as well, because they do so much amazingness, and then they can't remember like how much amazingness they've done and how much their family like loves and appreciates them. Thomas Mower also with the donation. I know it's not much. Don't get paid next week. Please don't ever feel like you have to, and please don't feel like it's not much. Like, anything is amazing. I'm currently drawing you, so far it's taken me 10 hours and I'm only halfway done. I'm having so much fun doing it. My grandpa is currently dealing with the disease. My granddad, sorry. He's at a stage where we have the same conversation after a few minutes. I know that stage. Love him so much. Thomas, thank you so, so much. We are at £1,537.75. We've really gone over the donation. You guys are so amazing. Thank you so, so much. Honestly, that is just crazy. I'm a Camden, just before I flipped off as well with the donation, £20. Love you, Claire. I hope you can have a wonderful day without your grandmother. Thank you so, so much for donating, Anna. Oh, you guys. Oh, emotional. Emotional times in today's stream today. I also want to catch up with you guys leaving messages in here as well. What is a good little emote we can use for this? Actually, the peachy love. Peachy love to say thank you from me, but also to show support for everyone having to deal with it. Peachy love in the chat, please. Lola Plays, thank you so much for being here for 2 months. And Corky Pie, thank you so much for being here for 5 months. Ayla, thank you so much for being here for 4 months. Hey Clay, you always make me smile. Also, we've got Eyebrow Twitch. Those memories are beautiful, Claire. I'm so sorry for your loss. I know it doesn't get easier, but more tolerable. I recently lost my grandfather to stage 4 cancer about 7 months ago, and it's hard even though we weren't really close, but I have to admit that I've been taking it hard. It's not easy, but more tolerable and numb, I think. I love you and have a beautiful day. Also, serious question, how does one go about becoming a moderator? One thing, will you be playing a game today? The mods in the chat will be able to help you out with those queries. And games today, yes. I'm kind of want to check in on what you guys fancy seeing today, because I know that there is a group playing Among Us, and it might be good to have a little bit more of a groupie vibe today, but I think they've currently got 10. And there might also be a queue as well, so we shall see, we shall see. We could play Phasmophobia as well. And also, Emily Ann, thank you so much for being here for 4 months. Just came back from Cambridge Hospital for my 1 year post scoliosis surgery. Oh wow, how has the recovery been? Let me know, Emily. Georgia, thank you so much for the bits. I could only donate £5, but I'm really glad I could help even a little bit. In case you forgot, I love you loads. Georgia, thank you so much. And also Miss Rachel, thank you so much for being here for 3 months. I really, really appreciate that. Peachy Simmer, thank you so much for being here for 3 months through Twitch Prime. I hope you're doing okay. I know this is hard, but you have all the peaches that are here to support you. Of course, of course. Bonnie Witchell, thank you so much for the bits. Love a good cause for raising money, especially when it's been promoted by a big influencer such as yourself. Thank you, Claire, for the amazing charity work you do. Love you. Thank you so, so much, Bonnie. Thank you. I think we should change our lights to celebrate getting to our goal. And I'm going to let you guys decide. So what color lights shall we go for? Pink, green, yellow. It can do all the colors, to be fair. Purple. We've also got... I mean, it's on blue at the moment. Orange. There we go. So let me know what you guys want as a little celebration for hitting the gold colour.
I got a gift for
it. Oh, it's a little Louvrush. A little Louvrush is here. What a baby. Look, we're on 1,566
pounds.
Well done. That's awesome, isn't it?
That's crazy. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you guys so, so much. Honestly, I'm all bunged up. Look what I found. Do you remember this? I read it out in the church.
Oh.
Yeah, and I read it out and cried the exact same bit.
She did that. She was so good.
I had to do it. I had to do it for my grandma. Orange for share the orange. That's such a good idea. Okay, if you want orange for share the orange, then make sure you vote orange. I like that idea. I'm going to vote orange as well. Carlotta, thank you so, so much for being here for 5 months. I appreciate that. Hugs to you all. Emily Mayner, thank you so much for being here for 5 months as well. Veggie Alex, welcome to the Peach Quads. Please say hi in the chat to Veggie Alex. Nicole EAA, thank you so much for showing love and letting me know that we reached the goal. Alex Ivan, thank you so, so much for the bits. Claire, what a beautiful family. Oh, thank you. Is that from the pictures in the book? I see YT1, thank you so much for being here for 5 months. I've only just joined the stream, but I'm so sorry for your loss. Sending you lots of peachy love. Thank you so, so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Jojo Best says, your emotions are so raw and honest. Keep doing what you're doing. Wishing you the best. Thank you so much. Sorry to get all upset on you guys on stream. I feel like I've done that to you guys so many times now. Lele, thank you so, so much for subscribing. Can we say hi to Lele in the chat? No, thank you so much for the bits. Hi, lovely. Sorry I'm a little late. You've been so strong and amazing over the last few years. She's incredibly proud of you, just like we are. We're always here for you. Love you always and stay strong. Thank you so much, Noor. Also, Bertha Gertrude Hornface, thank you so much for the bits. Unfortunately, I lost my grandma a couple of weeks ago. She had dementia. I'm so sorry to hear that. I can't donate today, but thank you for doing this. It runs in my family. My other grandma is developing it slowly. Oh, babes. I think about her every day. I feel so guilty. I'm deeply grieving, but I haven't even cried. I feel so bad. Don't feel like not being able to cry is kind of like a failing on yourself, or like you should be expected to react a certain way to situations. Oh my gosh, what won the poll, by the way, because I totally missed that. Because when I lost my aunt and my grandpa, I couldn't cry either. I actually got into a really weird hysterical state where like, I was like squeezing my hands, but I was grinning and I wasn't happy. I was just overwhelmed. I was a lot younger and I didn't really know how to handle that many emotions. So I just kind of got like a little bit overwhelmed. So don't feel like crying is the only way to react to grief. And don't feel bad if you can't. It was purple. Okay, here we go. There we go, purple background. Yeah, don't feel like crying is the only way. Hi, good. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out. Yeah, don't feel like crying is the only way to react, and don't feel bad if you can't cry. And also, you couldn't attend a funeral due to COVID. Does it ever get easier to cope? It does, and you start to like, I don't know, I feel like I appreciate her so much more now. I always did, but I wish I could tell her all the reasons why and all the ways she's amazing, and I can't. So I would just say, if there are people in your life that make you feel that way, make sure you tell them while you can. Mary Deathcon, thank you so, so much for the bits. Claire, that was beautiful. I'm sure she's watching over you and is so very proud of the wonderful woman you have become. Thank you so much, Mary. Mim Sims, thank you so much for being here for 5 months. Love you, Claire. Sending you so much love today. Thank you so, so much, Mimi. Sim Serum, thank you so much for being here for 5 months. We all love you, Claire. You're so strong. We are here for you. Grief is a lot. It comes in waves even after years. But just know you're incredibly strong and a good cry is really healthy. Yes, it is. I love a good cry. Michaela Jordan, thank you so, so much for being here for 3 months in a row. yay, 3 months, so proud of how strong you are. Thank you. You guys want to play marble? Okay, I'm going to do another poll. This time it will be for play. What shall we play next? So do you want to play marbles on stream? Do you want me to try and get into Among Us? Do you want me to try and get some Phasmophobia? Do you want me to try and play some Genshin Impact? Or there's also a game that I wanted to see what you guys thought of potentially playing, because it's actually, it's a game about someone struggling with Alzheimer's and dementia. And it's kind of like a little bit of a story-based game. It's called Before I Forget, so I'll put that on there as well. And also, if you do buy Before I Forget, some of the proceeds go towards Alzheimer's UK, so that's really cool. So there we go. I've got a little poll on screen now. You guys can let me know what you fancy. Panda Hope, thank you so much for the bits. Cooper Pia, thank you so much for being here for 5 months. I love you so much, Claire. You've helped me recognize my sexuality and gender. You are such a queen. I'm so sorry about your grandma. Love you. Cooper Pia, that's awesome news. I'm so, so glad that you figured those things out, and I hope you're happier for it. Kay Forster, thank you so much for being here for 5 months. Simdale, thank you so much for being here for 5 months as well. Here from the beginning. Love you, Claire. You're such an inspiration. I love what you do with this channel. You should be proud. You're an eco-warrior with a heart of gold. Literally my goal in life. Thank you. Tia loves Claire. Thank you so much for the bits as well. Please play whatever makes you happy today, Claire. We'll love it no matter what because we love you. You have no idea how incredibly proud we are of you. Thank you so much, Tia. Bok, thank you so much for the bits. Also, the standard greeting from NA. Hi, Claire. I'm at work. Well done for the fundraiser. Keep it going. Hi, Jay. Love you. You guys are so freaking cute. Daisy, thank you so much for being here for 5 months with your Twitch Prime. Hannah, thank you so much for the bits. I'm sorry I'm late. I managed to donate some birthday money. You're such an inspiration. I love you. Hannah, thank you so much for donating your birthday money. That's so sweet. Bunny B, thank you so much for being here for 3 months with your Twitch Prime. So sorry for your loss. I lost my grandma to Alzheimer's 2.5 years ago. She was the best person in the world and I miss her every day. 2 days later, I gave birth to my son. Oh, and when he smiles, I see my grandma's smile. You're amazing. Bunny Bee, that's so amazing. Oh, you nearly set me off crying again. That's so sweet. That is so sweet and amazing. If somebody in the chat just asked how to donate, so I've popped that little link back in there as well. That is like, that's such an amazing, nice thing. Oh, emotions. All the emotions are flowing out today. Also, I'm just gonna check back in on the donations real quick. Yes, okay, here we go. So we are now on £1,641 raised, which is amazing. Mirren, pronounced Mirren. Okay, thank you so much for letting me know how to pronounce. £5, Claire, no words or amount of money can bring back the person that you lost, but it can help you with losing someone else. When I was 4, I lost my granda, and I always hear stories, and the best thing was my aunt had a dog and he used to take it, and he forgot, he fed it a walk or took a walk. I'm so proud of you. Mirren, thank you so much for the donation. Dane! Dane's my brother. Dane, are you in the stream? Are you in the stream? I'm checking to see if I've missed a message from you. Dane, thank you so much. Thank you. Simply Mars, thank you so much for the donation as well. My grandma had Alzheimer's and forgot me when she was 12. When I was 12, and she passed away when I was 14. My granddad has dementia and he's in a home. I haven't been able to see him all year, both due to corona and also due to his health and state. He can no longer handle more than one to two people visit him at a time. This is for them. Simply Mars, £50. Thank you so much. That's amazing. Hannah, thank you so much for the £5 as well. Hey, Claire, thank you for doing this. I lost my grandma to Alzheimer's. You've truly helped me so much. Thank you. Thank you so much, Hannah. Also, the glittered kitten, thank you so much for the £5 donation. Much love. I lost my mum this year. She had the beginnings of dementia, and it was heartbreaking to see her lose herself. Your gran would be so proud of you. Thank you so much, the glitter kitten. I'm sure your mum would be so proud of you as well. JoeMeat1999, thank you so much for the £5 donation. Such a great cause to be raising money for. I lost my grandma to Alzheimer's. Love you. So many of you guys. £20. Love you, Claire. I hope that you can have a wonderful day without your grandma. And then Emma donating £5 as well. Thank you for doing this and raising awareness. I do research in neuroscience, and there is so much more to do to understand how to treat Alzheimer's and help those affected by it. 100%, which is why it's so important that we raise money to try and fund that research. So, Claire's brother, Jane. Hi, Dane. He's called Dane. He's my little brother. He's 3 years younger than me. And I never let him forget it. So yeah, it's so cute that he's here as well. I know both of us took it really, really hard. I think both of us still take it very hard. Because like I said, because we spent so much of our childhood with them, with my both my grandmas actually, but especially my grandma Marge, because she lived next door. It was really, really hard because, yeah, it was just really, really tough. Okay, I think you guys would like me to play Before I Forget. From what I can see, that is winning. So that is the game that is a little bit more about it's about somebody struggling with it. I don't really know what to expect, but we can definitely give it a go. I think it's gonna win. So I'm gonna go ahead and make sure it's all updated and ready to play as well. Claire, what about Ooblets? I don't have my save game on Ooblets. It's on my other PC. I might just have to try and get that save somehow. I thought it saved in the cloud, so I didn't transfer the save over, but I really wish I did. When are you going to play Genshin Impact with Diluc? I really want to play Diluc. I do really want to play him. Hopefully we'll get a chance soon. Oh my gosh, Among Us might overtake. The thing is, I don't know if... Before I forget. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and just do a little pause on the music. And also, I will get Before I Forget launching in the background. What did I put it on? I set this up already. Here, I think. £1,651. That is absolutely wild. That is absolutely wild. Okay, yay! Okay. Can you guys hear it? I'm gonna turn it up just to make sure you guys can hear it, okay? Because there is a little bit of music. Did she see the £500? Was there a £500 donation that I missed? I hope not. It's still showing the top donator is £200 for me. Yeah. Was there a £500? I don't know. I totally missed that. But yeah, this is Before I Forget. It's a really short game. It's actually less than an hour long. So I thought we would give that a go. I'm also going to just change my Twitch stream to make sure I'm saying what the game is that we're playing. So here we go. It is called Before I Forget. There we go. Boom. Okay, so this is like an indie game. It's actually won some awards. And like I said, you can hear it. Brilliant. Thank you for letting me know. The money that... If you buy this game, some money goes towards Alzheimer's UK. So I thought that was pretty cool. So let's go ahead and give it a go. It's best played through in one sitting. It's 1 hour. Okay. Loading now. Hydrate. Thank you, guys. I actually have a bit of a headache from crying. So that is a good shout. Okay, here we go.
Can you feel the dogs, my love?
No, they need their din-dins.
Come on, din-dins.
Subtitles are on, I think. Let me check. Text. Yeah, text will be like this. Can I make it a little bit bigger for you guys? There we go. And I'm pretty sure, yeah, I think it's got full subtitles. So here we go. I don't really know what to expect with this.
Where am I?
Okay, can you guys see the text okay? Glasses. Okay, we've got our glasses. Let's pop those on.
Is this the right place?
Oh my gosh, I love her accent. She's got like...
Dylan will know. I'll find him.
Is it her accent kind of sounds like Indian or Pakistan accent. It's really nice. Okay, we've got a note. I'm making sure you guys can see everything. Gas bill overdue. We'll sort it together.
Overdue? Why hasn't Dylan paid it?
Who's Dylan? Urgent, and that's the bill. Okay. Flat 1, 41, Cadogan Avenue in London. Okay, so we're in London. Find Dylan. Oh, look how many times she's written it. Okay, who's Dylan? Oh, guys, is this going to make us upset? I kind of feel like it is. We've got plants. The plants are happy. Honestly, the plants are doing better than my plants are. More bills. More bills by the door. And look, we've got the little red phone box outside. I love her accent too. Her accent's so pleasant to listen to. Okay, I'll just leave it with little lamp vibes because I think that's kind of cute. Okay, so this is like our little housey. Honestly, she lives in a nice neighborhood in London. Those houses that look like that in London are all like £3 or £4 million. Today is 2001, 12th of July. It's a Thursday. Here is another note. Dentist on the 18th, 10:30 a.m. Okay, well, we've
Dentist.
not...
I don't know where it is.
We know we've not missed the dentist appointments. That's nice.
How will I get there?
Everything's at... There's no colour, though. There's, like, no colour, is there? Oh, umbrella. Oh, can I turn this light on? That was freaking me out for a second then. Okay, we've got a suitcase. We've got an umbrella. I guess it's not actually raining, though, so we don't really need that.
I got caught in the rain that day in the park.
And then we've got...
But you offered to share your umbrella.
Should I move my face cam down so you guys can see it more?
We walked slowly, even though the rain got heavier.
I guess you can hear her. A memory.
How do you like Amsterdam?
It's beautiful, like stepping back in time.
A little memory there. So she went to Amsterdam. Have I got a bit more colour back? Wait, there's colour now. Was this black and white before? Now there's colour. I kind of feel like it is. Okay. What's through here? It's my little living room. She's got a beautiful house. A note. Don't keep moving this. Oh, it's a trophy. Scientific discovery of the year, 1975. Dr. Sunita Appleby. This is me. This is my character, isn't it? Sunita.
Wow, that sounds impressive. But I don't think it was me.
I kind of think maybe it was. 1975. Look, the colour's coming back into the room. And a picture. I wonder if that's her as well. Okay. A magazine. Oh my gosh. Modern scientist. Indian cosmologist. Sunita Appleby. Boldly going where no woman has been before. Build your own solar water heater. Cluster galaxies. So this was her.
That's me. But I'm not going anywhere.
She was like a...
I'm not going.
She was an award-winning scientist. Wow. Okay. Physical anthropology. She's forgotten, hasn't she? She's forgotten her past, that she was a scientist. Why?
Why what?
I was about to say the same thing. Is her at university?
That was before we met. I look so young.
Oh, and the colour's coming back into the room. The moon, because she was into cosmology. Am I saying that right? I keep almost saying like cosmetics, and I don't mean to say that. History, T. Goldberg. Okay, we've got butterflies on the wall here. I feel like there might be another memory in here because the colour hasn't fully come back in yet. But I don't think there's anything else I can click. I think that's everything. Still though, a bunch of colours come back in, so that's good. I think if we get her memories back, it's gonna bring colour back into her life. I think there's no colour right now because she's lost so many of her memories. Oh? Can you guys hear that?
Dylan? Are you here?
Okay. I never know. You. Oh, guys, this is gonna make
you
me really emotional.
You can't sing it yet.
Oh.
Your brother almost made you late that day.
On the wedding day. Guys. Live in concert. This is why they went to Amsterdam. It's him! Plays his Bat Goldberg Variations Amsterdam concert in Gabal. Anyone from Amsterdam in the chat? Let me know. Is that quite loud? Should I turn it down a little bit? So that's... she's calling out for him. For Dylan.
I can hear you playing. Where are you?
It's a little loud. Okay, I'm going to switch it down just a little bit. Maybe here. Perfume. Rose perfume. The colours come back into it.
It smells like roses.
She's so cute. And lipstick. And the colour's coming back into that as well. I love the colour coming back. That's a clever mechanic. Can I look in the mirror? No, I can't look in the mirror. Okay. I'm really scared that Dylan's not gonna be here. I'm scared it's gonna do that to us and he's just not gonna be there.
You bought me this in Paris.
Jeez, they had a great life, honestly. A great life. I'm from the Netherlands, there you go. Dinner at the bistro at 9 p.m. from Dylan.
What a lovely surprise. Our little bistro.
If something's happened to Dylan, we riot.
What time is it? Oh, I should get ready, put my makeup on.
It's only 9:15 in the morning, though. Should I make her do it now? Does she know?
It smells like roses.
Okay, we've already clicked those. Okay, I'm gonna go into the little bathroom here as well.
It's locked.
Okay. Do I need to get like a little key or anything? I feel like kind of maybe we've done everything in here. Look, the bed's only made on one side. Guys, I feel like it's gonna have a sad ending. I don't want it to have a sad ending.
Oh? I need the toilet.
Okay. But we can't get-
I'll go now before I meet Dylan.
We can't get into the bathroom though, can we? Oh gosh. No, that was back in there. Why is all the colour gone again?
Was it this way? They look the same. I can't- Oh, how silly.
She can't remember where the toilet is, can she? It's gone darker outside. How much time has passed? Oh god, I don't like it when he puts me into that kind of- Wait, what? It is darker outside. What? What? It's a different day. It's Friday. It's Friday. It's Friday. We've just lost a whole day.
Oh no, Hari Sunni, which door is it?
It's gonna keep looping me, isn't it? Why do I keep being in the cupboard? It's still Friday. Wait, what is that noise?
Rick, oh please.
Oh no! No, 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 no! I'm just gonna follow the corridor around. They've got a massive London house.
Where did that hole come from?
What? Okay, so I guess I can't go that way.
It's locked.
Oh, I'm panicking! I know what it's like to need to pee and not be able to pee because I have the tiniest bladder ever.
It's too late. I couldn't remember.
No. Look, she's...
Dylan... He's not there.
Guys, I don't think Dylan's here.
Oh, I hope he's put the kettle on.
I'm immediately gonna go and see what day it is, because I feel like we've lost another day. I also feel like, oh, it's open now. I can go in here now. There's loads of stuff stuck on the wall. What is that? Can you guys hear a phone? Has she got a phone in here? I can hear a phone. I can open this drawer though. Sheet music. I bet that's Dylan's. Oh god, I want to be- Oh, Dylan in the chart! I don't think Dylan's here either. I think she's forgotten that she's lost him. She can sit down on here. A postcard from Hawaii? What? Oh, from Dylan! Darling Dylan, Hawaii is magical, but I don't see much beyond the observatory. The scope is my... Oh, of course, because Hawaii has one of, like, the darkest skies, so it's really good for looking at space. The scope is marvellous and the team is too. I'm so glad the tour is going well. Make sure you look after yourself too. I know what you're like. Good news, I think I can arrive in San Francisco when you are here. Not too long to wait, but also too long to wait. Love always, Sunny. Oh my gosh, they had such a cute... Oh, he's in Austria. Of course, he's in Amsterdam. They had such a cute life together. Appleby wows the audiences. And a letter from the Grand Hotel. Darling Sunny, this is 72. Just a short note. Thank God for the hotel stationery. Otherwise, I would never know where I am on tour. Missing you desperately. Still haven't parted ways with this devil of a cold. I hope you're feeling better than I am. The Italian press are kind, so all is not lost. That's he was in Italy, in Milan. Dylan Appleby turns to composing. Appleby cancels Berlin concert. Wait, why? And then he conquered New York. Why did he cancel Berlin? Paris. Darling, dearest darling Sonny, your last letter found me tired, but buoyed by the promise of seeing you. I'm in hospital. I just want to say even French cuisine does not infiltrate these walls. Alas, no need to hurry to my bedside, although there is nothing I would like more. Don't read the papers. They exaggerate. I'm a little tired. That is all. Oh, guys. I'm just creating more inventive ways to get out of touring, what lengths I will go to. Being unable to work on my new piece is more than frustrating. Cosmos is swirling around in my head, but I must have more time to get down on paper. There is no piano in hospital, so I cannot practice. I am plotting my escape. Don't worry, I'll be out before you know it, or there will be blood, not mine. By the time you read this, we may already have spoken. I just think, I think you have the right number now. Love always, and from D.
I should phone Dylan. Is he okay?
So he was in hospital, but she can't remember this. Touring is torment, says Appleby. He didn't enjoy touring, did he? Sydney Opera House celebrates Appleby's return. And I can't... Oh, another letter. Here we go. Hotel Ritz in Paris. Dearest darling Sunny, I am writing this while sipping a rather delicious Malbec. Oh, man after my own heart. While enjoying the hubbub of the Canal Street Martin, a rare moment of repose. Of course, I tell you this only in the hope that you will be so envious on missing me so terribly that you rush to me. Failing that, I get to San Francisco on the 27th of May. Might you be able to tear yourself away from the cosmos? I wanted to stay in our favourite Felipe, but Adrian and co failed to see its charm, so I'm dining in this lavish life near the opera. They tell me the tour is going well. I'm trying to write that piece about the stars. This must be inspired by her. But with so little time, it's difficult to get anything more than a few ideas down. I yearn for more than a fleeting moment. I shall return home soon, but not soon enough. The back is a moment I steal to myself each night. The adrenaline, the audience doesn't notice anyway. It will end soon and we will be together again. Until then, my sweetest, all my love, Dylan. Guys, what happened to Dylan? We must know what happened to Dylan. Oh my gosh. Look at the date on the letters. Oh yeah, that's a really good point. So that one was 12th of the 4th. So 12th of April. And then...
I should phone Dylan. Is he okay?
That one was... Oh, the 3rd of February. So that one's actually older. Thank you so much for the note, for the reminder. And that's okay. So that one is the last one. The one where he's not well is the last one. Okay. I think that's all
I'm
of the letters.
I'm glad he's back now. He is, isn't he?
I'm worried he's not. I'm really worried he's not.
It's lonely here without him.
I need to find this phone. Okay. Is it back this way? I also need to see what day it is. Okay. It's definitely a different day because it's different outside. Why does it look so scary in here? Okay. There we go. It's Saturday. Okay, so we have lost a whole day. They're from 1972. Yeah, that's what I mean. I feel like this is when they were a lot younger than they are now. Where is your phone?
I don't want to fall.
Oh my gosh, no. Wait, let's switch it back on. Don't fall.
Not going that way.
Okay, she doesn't like that part of the house. Is your phone in here? No. I can't find the phone. She's got some pills she's meant to be taking. S. Appleby. Donne Pezzle. Does anybody know what that is? One tablet to be taken a day after food.
Should I take them? I don't feel sick. They can't be for me.
She's not going to be able to remember to take her tablets, is she? I feel like there's something else to click. Oh no, the colour is coming back. Okay. I can't find this phone. I'm going to try this room.
Not going that way.
Yeah, she really does not like that other side of the house. That's locked. But I need you to go this way because of the phone. Oh, she's really freaked out by that. Okay, we're not going that way. She doesn't like it. There's this door here. Okay, let's try this one. It's a dementia medication. Ah, thank you for letting us know. Wait, where's the phone? I,
I can't find her phone. I feel like the phone is in the direction she won't go. I can't find a phone. Wait, have I been in here? No, this is a new room. A phone! Yes! No!
Hi, it's Maria from the care agency. I've been ringing all morning. Please pick up the phone. Sunita? I will be there soon. Remember, I have a key, so I'll let myself in.
Okay, that's from the care agency.
Who was that? How does she know my name?
Okay.
She said she's coming for me.
And then this is, look, this looks like him, Dylan Appleby.
But I'll wait for Dylan.
Piano Variations, Winter Ocean. Site A, Pale Moonlight Lake, Winter, White Water, River, Denial, Slowly Sinking, and T-Top. Winter Solstice, November, Frosted Winds, High Tide, and Icy Greatness. Okay, and then he's got more records here. He's got a bunch of records. I want to see if he ever did the Cosmos one. But I can't see the Cosmos one anywhere. Greetings from India! This is to Sunita, 1971. Dearest daughter Sunny. This is her ma and is it Baba? Dearest daughter Sunita, all is well here. Well, except the gardener has returned. No, the what has returned? Something has returned. And I think the new one is stealing from the pantry. Daddy won't deal with it and told me not to bother. And few bits, but it's the principle. We are delighted that you found a home. When are you coming to visit? You both seem so busy. When will you have time to start a family? You can't wait too long. Daddy told me not to meddle, but it's not meddling. I'm your mother. Oh, literally pressuring them to have kids. Postcards never have enough room. I'll write a letter soon. Tell us your news, all my love, Mama and Baba. So that's her parents back in India.
Must give them a ring. I haven't spoken to them in ages.
I don't feel like that's going to be very nice news for her either when she learns about that. Oh, she's got emails. Dylan, 1995. This is the archive. Hi, Sunny. I finally created an email just for myself, so I'm writing to you from America. The tour is going well, although I've missed you very much. See you in a week, all my love, D. Then Klaas van der Meer. Sunita, what happened? I heard the event was a disaster. After all these months of work, if you weren't confident presenting, I could have rearranged my schedule and stepped in. We should talk. Give me a call. Oh no, she did badly on a presentation. Desmonda Archer. Hi, Sunita. I just heard that you're retiring. She retired right after that. Are you all right? What about your research? I'm so shocked. Has Dylan convinced you to start a family? You don't have to give up everything. I can't believe you're going. Let's talk. I'll pop into your office for a cuppa. That's from Mona. Mona also said, sorry, I haven't been in touch. This was like almost a year later, at least 6 months later. No, more than a year later. I don't know if you're still picking up your emails, so I'll try and give Dylan a call and we'll try and get together or something. Do you think in 96 is when she started showing symptoms? I think maybe. I can't view her inbox. I can only see her archive. It won't, look, she's got 239 emails and I can't click any of them. If I log out, she's not gonna be able to get back in, is she? But I can't click anything else. I have to log out.
What does class mean, disaster?
Oh, no. Wait, I can sit.
You always made things difficult, but I could never say anything.
Oh, she had a bad boss. No!
This is your favorite spot to sit, scribbling a new piece.
We're losing some more time. But we've got Dylan's piano and a little burp in the little water fountain. I don't think the game's scary. I think it's just going to be sad. The game is set in 2001, so 1996 would have been 5 years before that. Yeah, that's a really good point. That's a nice little scene. I like the piano music. We've got a letter. Institute of Scientific Research and Culture. This is 96. This is when she retired. On behalf of the whole faculty, I want to thank you for your peerless contributions to the research and standing of this university. Your work has left a mark on the institution in the field of cosmology. I speak for myself and all my colleagues when I say that we are grateful to have had the opportunity to work with you on a personal and professional level. Thank you for everything and we wish you all the best for your retirement and managing your condition. Yours sincerely, Desmond Powell. So it's saying about the condition, isn't it?
What condition? I'm fine.
This is the, yeah.
I'll call him. It's just a misunderstanding.
So she retired because of it.
I've also got a star map. Ooh, a memory.
Okay, you show me then, clever clogs.
Is this Dylan?
That's no fun, Dylan. You have to find it yourself.
As you wish, Professor.
Not yet, I'm not.
Oh, Sism would have been a long time ago.
It's just a matter of time. So, guide me to this star.
It's not a star, but all right. First, find Pegasus towards the bottom of the map.
Will I get to control this?
Pegasus.
Oh, it's me. Pegasus. Here.
Ah, got it.
Its body is a giant box dipped on its corner, and the top left corner of the box is Alpha Rats.
Is it this? There. Is it a square?
This one?
That's it.
Hey, I'm getting good at this.
Oh, so that's like the Pegasus cluster thing?
No, count two stars up and follow along to the right. From there to Andromeda.
Follow along to the right. Two stars up, one there.
Right. So, what am I looking at?
The Andromeda Galaxy. It's 2.65 million light years away. And you can actually see it with the naked eye on a clear night.
I've never seen it before. Imagine I want that. To see it.
Wow. You must show me properly. Sonny, do you think there could be another you and me in Andromeda looking back at us?
Maybe.
She thinks no.
You know, my Leela auntie used to tell me the stories of the gods and the stars, but I can't really remember them now.
That was a nice memory. Have any of you guys been able to see Andromeda before? I didn't know you could do that either. I want to do that. From there to Andromeda, we got an achievement for that. This whole room's bright now.
What was I doing? Oh yes, Dylan. Where is he?
Wait, it's night. Is it nighttime? No. No, we're okay. We're okay. We're okay. Is there anything else to view in here before I leave this room? No, I think we've got everything. I still can't go across the hallway. But we've brought light into a bunch of rooms. Colour, sorry, even to a bunch of rooms. Wait, should I check what day it is?
Maybe he's taking a bath.
Okay, we know where the bathroom is.
Not in here. Where are you?
Oh, I feel like she's going to find out some really sad news about Dylan, guys. I really do.
So, Sunny to the cosmologist, how about a coffee? There's a cafe over there.
Well, if that's the way the umbrella's going, maybe I should. A cup of tea would be nice. I hope Dylan's put the kettle on.
Oh, I don't want to find sad news out about Dylan. This is one of my fears of the person I love leaving before me.
Not
she
going
can't
that
go
way.
That way still. Like, I don't want to be left without Ali. Like, I literally worry about that so much. I want to grow old with him and not having him by my side would be so hard. So hard. Okay, what have we got here? Peaches! Guys, she has peaches! Yes! Queen! And a note. Sunita, do not use the stove. Your lunch is in the fridge. Maria.
I shall use the stove if I want to.
Who is Maria?
Who is Maria?
Is that the care worker? Ham went off. I got you some cheese.
That's silly. I bought ham yesterday.
Oh, wow. A bunch of notes in here. Takeaway. Taj Mahal. Takeaway in restaurant. Oh, look. She circled what she likes. Chicken and saag balti and coconut rice. That's what she likes to eat.
Maybe we can get a takeaway tonight. Then we don't have to cook.
And a note. Lunch in here. Okay. Someone's trying to help her.
Who is leaving these notes?
Buy peaches.
We always need more peaches.
It's true. We could always have more peaches. No more peaches. No, no, don't say that.
But Dylan loves peaches.
I'm gonna open the fridge. Okay, we've got a sandwich. So I can eat a cheese sandwich.
I don't like cheese.
Oh, she doesn't
so
like cheese.
So bland.
What vegan queen?
Dylan knows that. Why would he make me cheese? Maybe he's getting forgetful.
There's a lot of cheese as well. This is all she's got in her fridge. Milk, bread, and cheese. Who keeps bread in the fridge? That's weird. Okay, I better close that. Do you guys keep your bread in the fridge? Oh, is this going to be safe for me to put the kettle on? Oh no. We're losing time again. Oh, but it's the piano again. What kind of game is this? Is it 18 plus? No. This is a game that is meant to kind of be a representation of dementia and Alzheimer's. Autumn the Simmer, thank you so much for being here for 3 months. Oh my gosh, 3 months is so cool. Thanks for doing this. My grandpa has Alzheimer's and I'm one of his caretakers. It's really scary seeing someone you've loved your whole life lose their mind. I'm so sorry you're going through that, Autumn. Bodines, welcome Bodines. Please say hi to Bodines too in the chat there in New Peachy. Amy loves Kalia, thank you so much for the bits. Please check donations again if you can. I will do, Amy. I think when we get to the end of this game, we've lost a bunch more time there.
I thought perhaps now the tour is over, we could start trying.
Let's wait. Just until my research is finalized.
She didn't want kids really, but he did. She's remembering that. Look how many peaches, by the way. Like, a lot of peaches. Her mum was pressuring her to have kids as well. Can I just not make myself a cup of tea? It will keep fast forward in time. Okay. So definitely can't make a cup of tea. It's still Friday.
Now the tour is over, we could start trying.
It's his tour, isn't it? His music tour's over, so he wants to start a family. But she doesn't want to start. Okay, I've got another picture here. Can I view that? They're so cute. Look how cute she is. Little Christmas picture.
Which year was that? We look older.
I think this is why she can't look in the mirror, isn't it? Because she's going to look a lot older than that. Gosh, that's a weird looking door. And then we've got a little kitchen table here. A telescope! Look, the stars! This is so cleverly done, isn't it?
A clear sky. Perfect.
Is this younger her?
Show me one with the story, Lila Auntie.
This is little her.
All right.
Is this
Let's
this is
start
in India?
With an easy one. This is Taurus, the bull. Look to the east.
Northeast.
Can you find the star at the tip of one of the horns?
Yay. Okay, I think those are the horns.
This is how she got her love for the stars in the sky, isn't it?
Got it.
That's Svaha. She was desperately in love with Agni, the god of fire. His love was focused elsewhere.
That's sad. But I suppose at least she's a beautiful star now.
Her voice is so
True.
Cute.
Show me another, Auntie.
Do you remember she said...
Let's see.
She couldn't remember the stories
this time,
her aunt
I will
told
show
her, but
you
now she
a
can.
Constellation in the west.
My grandma
it has
could
three stars close together.
Remember stuff from
Can
her like
it?
When she was really young, but then she wouldn't
no,
be able to remember what she talked about
there
2 minutes
are too
ago.
Many.
Don't give up so easily, Suni. This star's light has traveled so very long just so you could see it. Would you want its journey to be wasted?
How long?
Thousands and thousands of years.
Fine, I'll look again.
Look for the brightest star over to the west.
The west, here.
I see it.
Now head straight up, and there will be three stars in a row.
I see it. What is it called, Auntie?
Is that the Orion's Belt?
Prajapati. One day,
you can always
Prajapati
see the Orion's Belt where we live.
Chasing one
it's
of
really
his
cool.
daughters. The god saw. And wanted to punish him. They called on Rudra, the god of storms and thunder, and asked him to punish Prajapati. He shot an arrow, which flew fine and true, and pierced Prajapati's waist.
Jeez.
Those three stars you see are Rudra's arrow.
That's a bit of a violent story, isn't it?
How do you know these stories?
When I was your age, Baba took me out to show me how everything that seems to matter doesn't really matter. The stars show us how small we are.
Anyone in the chat have, like, Indian heritage? And, like, this is... Because I'm guessing those star stories are different to, like, the Greek heritage stuff that seems to be, like, the mainstream
one. Lilandi? Where? Where did she go?
Oh, wow, we're in a completely different room from that. Okay. Wow. Okay, she travelled the house while that was happening. But yeah, if you have Indian heritage, let me know in the chat if, like, you have got Bengali heritage. Oh, it's a clock. I thought it was footsteps and I got a bit freaked out.
He's in the kitchen.
Oh, she keeps thinking he's here. Okay, at least we know where the kitchen is now. She still won't go to the other half of the house. And I still can't light up this hallway yet. But... Oh, no, I can. I can go down there now, but she says the kitchen, the kitchen. But he's not. And another picture, I found another photo. That's really young. Look at the hairstyles.
That door was grueling, but we stole a moment in San Francisco.
Man, it's kind of sad that they worked so much. I think they loved their jobs, which is nice. But they keep wishing they had more time together. Mementos, plane tickets. Amsterdam to London. That is in 29th of November. I can't see a year though. Doesn't say what year it is. 94.
Amsterdam. That's where we met.
Oh, that's why they keep going back to Amsterdam, because they met there. Oh?
Breakfast in bed, Mrs. Appleby?
So they just got married.
Sounds perfect, Mr. Appleby.
Get you a man that will bring you breakfast in bed, gang. I've got a card here as well. Congratulations. Wait, show me it again.
I miss her stories. I should visit her soon.
I missed that. Who was that from? Quick, let me click it. There we go. Dearest Sunita, congratulations on your place at Cambridge. You really are following your dreams of going to the stars. From Auntie Leela. Oh, her family's so cute though.
I miss her stories. I should visit her soon.
And then we've got more sheet music from Dylan as well. I can't really read sheet music. I could at one point, but that's all just gobbledygook to me. And okay, we've brought quite a lot of colour back to this room. But there's still some bits I can't bring the colour back to yet. Here we go. Birthday card. Happy 40th. To my darling Sunita, I love you more every year. Happy birthday. So that's
you
from him.
You always spoil me on my birthday.
Okay, so we've got some colour here. And then, can I look at this picture or anything? No, I can't get the luster of the colour. Read channel 106! Oh, this is vibey. It's Christmas. Wow, is it like 70s Christmas? This is when they moved in. What? They knocked through, look. This was wall was intact. They knocked through.
I'm so glad I persuaded him to get a tree for our first Christmas here.
First Christmas. When did they get married? What year was it? Congratulations on our new home. Oh, Sunny and I can't read it. Sully and Dylan, you're such an inspiration to us all. We love you. Be happy always from Jenna and Clark.
It's all a bit of a blur.
Oh no.
Okay. It didn't rain though, even though Jenna thought it should.
And a card. Oh wow! Congratulations on your wedding. All our wishes, the orchestra. I guess the orchestra would know him because he's
so
a conductor, right? And a
friends.
Composer.
What did I come out here for?
On your special day, from Ma and Baba, our thoughts and prayers are with you both. And then also...
I wish they could have been here.
They weren't here. Congratulations to my two favorite people. Enjoy your life together and many happy years in this flat. All my love from Errol.
Errol didn't forget the rings, at least.
Oh, was that... Is that his brother? I reckon that's Dylan's brother. And look, this is her award. So it's got to be before... It's got to be around 1975 or after 1975 because the award is there. And this is all their moving stuff. That's the picture.
Sunny! Sunny, come look at this.
Where would you go if you could go back in time?
If it was possible, I'd stay just here and now.
You have no brothers. I have a brother. I got
you
one little brother.
Then. Like you knew something. A marvelous secret.
She didn't want to change time because she wanted to stay with him. No, guys, we're back away from the vibey 70s vibes. We're back to present day. Okay, we've got color back in almost all of this room. Oh, there's dinner here.
I'll set a place for Dylan. He'll be here soon.
I don't think he will. Also, how did that dinner appear there? We didn't do that. She set up a little table. Look, she set a
It's getting late.
A plate for him. She's not eating anything either.
Make us a cup of tea before bed.
She's not eating. My grandma, Madge, did not eat a thing. It was really frustrating because she was losing so much weight. And then she wouldn't be able to fight off illnesses and stuff. A teacup on the floor. What's that doing there? It's got a little planet. It's got Saturn in it. Yeah, she couldn't fight off sicknesses because she there was nothing to her. She was just skin and bones. And we're back here.
I want to know all the stars, Leela auntie.
We should be heading home now.
In India, do you say the name before,
no,
like auntie?
Auntie,
instead of auntie Leela?
Please.
It's like Leela auntie?
The seven rishis.
I know, like life in the Mahabharata?
Precisely, Sunni. The rishis were the seven sages.
Yeah, you say the name first. Thank you, fandom universe.
With its light.
I didn't know that.
What else did they do?
Well, first, the rishi married Kritika, the seven sisters, and they all lived happily in the north sky. Come on, so look north.
Okay, we're going to try and find a star again.
I'm looking.
I like doing this, it's cute.
Can you see the four in a box?
Yes.
Oh, I see it.
Such a good astronomer, guys. Oh, one more.
Six, seven... What happened to them?
I keep checking your guys' chart.
One day, the rishis prepared an offering to Agni, and he emerged from the flames. He instantly fell in love with the sisters.
But he couldn't be with them because they're married.
Exactly.
So what did he do?
He was tormented by his love for the Kritika and took to wandering. One day, in the forest, he met Svaha, who loved him, although he didn't know it. She disguised herself as six of the seven sisters.
What, all in
did
one?
Did it work? Did he love her forever?
Sadly, no. The rishi thought their wives had been unfaithful and left them.
Nobody was happy.
These
Not
stories
story
also
can
suck.
Have a happy ending, Sunni. Not even for the gods.
Jeez, those poor wives, they didn't do anything wrong. In sidereal astronomy, I'm a Cancer instead of a Leo. What's sidereal astronomy? I'm a Leo, but I don't feel very Leo. Why am I in the, I'm in the closet. What is that noise?
Where are you, Dylan? Why are you never here? I need to know.
What is going on? Why is it all red? Is it from this? Oh gosh. Okay. Appleby Wells, Wells La Sala audiences. It's gonna be about him, isn't it? Dylan Appleby conquers New York. We're gonna find out what happened, aren't we? Appleby wows LaSalle's audiences. Oh guys, I feel really like we're gonna have some horrible news. I can't like read the walls very well because it's out of reach. Exhaustion plagues Dylan Appleby, claims critics.
Maria from the Care Agency, I've been ringing all day. Please pick up the phone.
I thought perhaps, now the tour is over.
Why is it so emotional? Young pianist crowned master at 21.
Where would you go?
Classical world loses Dylan Appleby. Dylan Appleby disappears.
No, you just decided.
I don't want to talk about this. Not when you're like this.
Why did we always come second?
You didn't. You were pressuring me.
We always said, though.
Well, things changed.
Exactly.
It's about kids.
You changed. But you never told me.
Oh, God. She didn't want kids. She didn't want kids. Oh, gosh. Why is it so relatable? Bat Goldberg Variations by Dylan Appleby. Did they break up? Saw this coming, didn't we? Scripture reading, eulogy. Who had the world at his fingertips and the cosmos in his arms? That's his brother reading it. A time for personal reflection. The Lord's Prayer. Closing hymn. There is a green hill far away. What happened to him?
I must be reading this wrong. What's it saying?
Sheet music. Song for Sunita. He wrote this in 98, just before. Look, it's in November. Is this what's playing now? I think this is what's playing, isn't it? I bet that was the piece that he was writing about the stars. It was her. What else can I discover in here? Here. What happened to him? What happened? Concert pianist Dylan Appleby dead. World-class composer and concert pianist has died in the early hours of yesterday morning. According to emergency service, he was involved with a car accident and died on arrival to St. Mary's Hospital. Known for his poetic compositions for piano as well as vibrant and moving performances, he was both popular with audiences and classical music establishment, winning very many awards. He leaves behind his wife, Sunita Appleby. No other casualties. His latest album is due to be released on Friday. A tribute to his wife, entitled Song for Sunita. Millennium Wheel, jeez. Nearing completion. A Northern Ireland power share. Wow.
No. No, you can't be.
Guys.
I can still hear you playing. How did it happen? Why did you leave? It wasn't your career that would get put on hold.
I stopped touring. What did you want me to do?
I don't know, Dylan, but what I do counts.
What's that supposed to mean?
I didn't mean that. Dylan, wait!
Oh, jeez. So he stopped touring so that they could try and start a family, but during the time she changed her mind. I don't, maybe she never wanted one. She wanted to focus on her career and not upset. And then he got in the car. And that's how he got into the car accident, because they had an argument and he was driving while he was angry. Oh, the poor
thing. You always wanted us to slow down and start a family. I was happy to be just us and our careers. But I kept forgetting things.
Oh, jeez. This is emotional, man. Oh, I'm back here again, but it's like all cloudy. Okay.
I got confused. I forgot myself. But then you were gone. And I forgot that too.
Is that him there? Oh, jeez, guys, I'm sorry. This has been such an emotional stream so far. I've cried about 3 times today, just on this stream alone.
We can be together now.
What does that mean?
Now, I remember.
What does she mean we can be together now? I thought at first Dylan might be like her son or like a kid, but obviously she never had them, did she? Gosh, I need some more peach juice. My throat's like all dry and scratchy. Oh. I think she died, yeah. Wow. Oh my gosh, guys, I'm gonna do a poll. In fact, mods, it'll lose the music if I click off. Would we be able to put a poll up to see if people like the game or not? Jeez, it was called Before I Forget. Oh, too much emotion today, I swear to God. It was depressing, it was super depressing, but it was very beautiful. It was really nice. But wow, I'm holding back tears now as well. The music is really nice. Really nice music. Oh man. Thank you. I really liked that, but that was really sad. That for me was sadder than Life is Strange. Oh. That was super sad. What is dementia? Blanky4, if you do exclamation mark and the word dementia, it will bring you to a website to help you learn more. Thank you, Hufflepugs. She's with Dylan again, yeah. Oh, gosh. All the playtesters helped over development. Oh. This is the cute pictures that we saw as well. Oh, I have such a scratchy throat. Oh. It was sad, but very beautiful. It's nice that they're back together again. If you heard my voice going. Emotions, they're just washing over me. I'm like, you know that gif of what film is it? Is it Spirited Away, where he's just in the sea and it's all the feels? That's what I am right now. I don't think she killed herself. I think she was old and she was going that way anyway. And I think like in her final moments, she was remembering everything. And then she passed away. It doesn't give me the vibe that she killed herself. I feel like she just passed away. She died of old age, yeah. Oh gosh, now I remember. Oh guys, so sad. So sad. I am gonna switch back to the donations because you guys are telling me I'm gonna put some music on that's a bit more, make us feel a little bit less sad, okay? I'm gonna put some music on. There we go. Hopefully that's not too loud. Let me know. And I'm going to switch back to Chrome so we can check in on the donations because, jeez. Oh, emotional. Okay, what we were on here, weren't we? There we go. What is the poll saying as well? You guys loved it. 73% of you loved it, 23% of you liked it, and 4% of you said not really your thing, which is fair enough. I think the red light followed her into heaven. Yeah, I think that too. Okay, so we're on £1,751 raised. Michaela's donated £5. Hey, Claire, I just want to say you're a great streamer and I love how you... I added a lot of loves there. How much you support great causes. I know it's not much, but I hope it helped. It's amazing. Thank you so much, Michaela. Joanna, £5 as well. Great cause, Claire. Love from Germany. Thank you so, so much. Jack, £5. I lost my granddad to Alzheimer's 3 years ago this November. He was so cheery and always had a big smile on his face when I was around him. It's so heartbreaking to see him develop dementia. Thank you so much for doing this. I'm so sorry you had to go through losing your grandma to this disease. I'm so sorry that you went through this as well, Jack. Amy Loves Callie, thank you so much for the £5 donation. I'm so sorry I missed the goal. I had my math tutor. No worries. But you're truly amazing for doing this. You're going to help so many people. Your grandma will be so proud of you. Thank you so much, Amy. Lily Bear, thank you so much for raising £5 as well. I bet your grandma is ultimately proud of everything you've achieved over the past 2 years. I know this isn't much. Don't say that. But every little helps, like Tesco always say. But I really want to donate to this amazing cause. You make me smile and laugh, especially when I need it the most. I love you. Thank you so much, Lily Bear. Kelly Fleming, thank you so much for the £20. You're an amazing person and streamer. Love that I can donate to this important cause. Thank you so, so much. Taylor McHugh, £20 as well. I lost both my grandmothers to Alzheimer's. I hope we can find answers too. Me too, Taylor. And Karina, Karina Straight Ruler, £5 as well. Took me a while to figure out how to do it, but I'm really happy to donate. I've never been touched by this, but my heart goes out to those that have. Wish I could donate more, but at least I can do something. Keep doing everything you're doing, sending peachy love. H2O Queen as well, £5. Claire, I feel as though I can live my life vicariously through your eyes, although I wish your pain could be replaced with the abundance of smiles. Through your experiences, you continue to be the queen that you are and shine a light for others. I'm so proud of you, Eco Warrior. H2O Queen, that's so sweet. Thank you. Nyenke, am I saying that right? Nyenke Stable, £20. I'm glad everyone has decided to ignore your grandma's advice of keeping money a prisoner. This community is amazing and I wish everyone the best. It is amazing. Thank you so, so much. Used to be like, keep it a prisoner. Keep it a prisoner. Also, we've got Moonlight Paladin, who's donated £5 as well. My grandma passed away from Alzheimer's last year. From Alzheimer's, he migrated to Germany when he was around 15 and would forget English. I'm bilingual and speak German, so I would have to translate for my family whenever we would visit him in the hospital. So that's interesting. So he migrated from Germany, so he remembered his mother tongue. And Emma as well, £10. Thank you so much for raising awareness. Oh, you mentioned about the neuroscience thing. Thank you so, so much. Everybody, thank you. Thank you so, so much. £1,751. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. I'm going to go for a quick top up my juice because I've got a really scratchy throat. So I recommend that we all go and grab some juicies now. Has the dashboard come up at the same time? Yeah, it has. I'm gonna go ahead and grab some juicies. I recommend that you guys grab some juicies as well. And should we go and grab some juicies? Then we'll figure out what game we're gonna play next, because I think Josh wants to play Phasmophobia. So, but I will do a little poll and we'll see what we want to do. So I'm gonna go and grab some juicies. Back in a moment.